back to another battle report here with a first-timer, Matt. And he's bringing one of the first, I think maybe the first time we've seen Necrons on the channel. So we're going to take a few minutes here just to talk with Matt and see what he's all about. So how long have you been playing 40K, Matt?
Since I was 14, so that's 17 plus years.
All right, so you've been playing a long
time. Yeah, I've been playing a long time. I just got in as soon as second edition was going out the door and third was coming in. And I've been playing Necrons since then.
Okay.
I've had plenty of armies. I've gone down in armies. I currently only have two now out of, used to having six of them.
Okay.
So I've gone up and down in armies.
Okay, so you're literally a lifer for Necrons.
Yes, okay. Definitely.
That's probably around the time that I stopped playing, early 90s.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So you've been playing Necrons a long time, and what do you think of Necrons in 8th?
They're pretty good. The characters lost a lot of their, I think, character to fit it into
till the codex.
Yeah,
anyway.
Yeah, till the codex. So I find that the characters are a little bit their toughness has gone down big time.
Okay.
The units have gained a lot of toughness. The back in the day, Necrons used to be able to get up, and you'd lose them, and now they just get up and constantly get up now. So that's a big buff to them. So the only way you can take them out now is wiping out the whole unit.
Yeah, it's
so
tough.
It's pretty good. That's pretty nice. But they lost a lot of their movement for the teleports and stuff like that, which is a downer.
Yeah.
The monolith is okay now. It wasn't useless in 6th and 7th edition. But now it seems to be okay. And with the new fact, it made it a lot better. But they had their ups and downs. 8th is looking okay. Let's hope they get a buff, a little bit of a buff in the codex.
Yeah. It's the Space Marine Codex, which was just the leaks are all out, seems to give a lot of the stuff back to the Space Marine Codex lost with the index that people were crying about.
Yeah.
So I think people are hopeful that you'll get your relics and stuff. Yeah, back
exactly.
So I don't know when that's gonna be though.
I'm hoping before Christmas. I'm hoping I'm 1 to 10 before Christmas.
Yeah.
So let's hope November. I'm hoping to get my codex for my birthday. So
we'll see.
A good birthday gift if it comes out.
We'll see.
Yeah.
I'm hoping I have enough firepower to take this army out. I don't know if I do.
Yeah. 40 warriors is quite intimidating in any edition it was. And Necron warriors are the linchpin of a Necron army.
Yeah.
So
I have a box of Necrons sitting over there that I bought for $200 with 60 warriors in it. But I don't know if I'm going to get around to doing it. But that's what drew me to Necrons, actually. Just like a phalanx of regenerating things.
I own about 170-something of them, and they're all painted. So, and 130 of them are painted in that orange color scheme, which has three coats of orange on them.
Yeah,
very striking. Was very painstaking process.
I can imagine.
Yes.
People who paint orange or Imperial Fist, they get my thumbs up.
Yeah. So, it's a good color for someone who's colorblind. Complete black, white. So, having an army that pops out at you means you can see them on the battlefield. You're not going to forget someone, so...
Okay, well, what do you think about our game today?
It's going to be fun. It's going to be good practice for Bloodbath. I'm looking forward to it.
Okay, I think it's going to be a tough game. We'll get on and come back with the army lists.
All right, here is my 2,000 points of Dark Angels, Lion's Blade Strike Force. This is the list I'm working on for Capital City Bloodbath. And that's what Matt wanted to play, so here we go. This force is led by Azrael, who of course is stock. With him is a Tech Marine, and no Power Axe, but there's a Chainsword. I still have to change that. Then we've got two Everseer Assassins. And then we've got the Primaris Lieutenant, who's just stock. And we've got Saint Celestine by herself, who of course is stock. Behind them we have a Dark Shroud with Heavy Bolter. Then we have a squad of Devastators with four Laz Cannons and a Cherub. Then we have a squad of 9 Bolter Scouts. We have a Venerable Dreadnought with twin Autocannon and twin Laz Cannon. And the Armored Lion at the back. Two Predators, all Laz Cannons. and 4 Razorbacks with Twin Assault Cannons. And that is about 2,000 points. And I believe that is 3 for Battleforged, 1 for Supreme Command Detachment, 1 for heavy support elite one, so Vanguard, and so that makes 5, and then 6 for Azrael, so 6 command points in total, and that's my force.
The Satan of Deceiver.
So which one? Sorry to interrupt you. Which one of the HQs is who here?
So this is Zandric.
They all look the same to me. Okay, this is Zandric,
and this is his bodyguard, Oberon.
Okay. Oh, he's the guy who can, like, take wounds for him, right?
Yeah, and teleport around.
Okay.
And then I have Orkin the Diviner. He's a good cryptic that turns into a star god.
This guy here?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, he's the guy who grows.
Yeah.
Okay, okay.
He kind of turns into a mini star god there.
Cool.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that's my Deceiver. And
That's his Satan?
Satan of Deceiver.
Okay,
yeah.
Cool.
Then I got a 6-man Scarab squad there.
Scarabs, okay.
Yeah. Then I have 4-man destroyers with a upgraded heavy destroyer.
And that's the guy with like the double barrel there in the middle?
Yeah.
No, that guy at the back. Right, okay.
Yeah, cool. He's the best las gun in the las cannon in the game.
Okay.
Strength 9, AP 4, or sorry, minus 4 to your armor save.
Cool.
And then it's 20-man blob. 20-man blob of warriors.
Okay.
Then a 6-man immortal squad with Gauss blasters.
Yep.
And my 6 race with trans-dimensional beamers.
Okay.
They pretty much do mortal wounds on 6s.
Okay.
And their strength for AP, not AP anymore, minus 3 to your armor save.
Yeah, it is AP.
Yeah, it's just kind of like
still
AP.
Called AP, yeah, but now it's just yeah. Okay, cool. So that's 2,000 points, Necrons, and how many command points you have?
4.
Okay, so you just got. So what is this?
So I just got my stock 4, and I don't know if the missions get 3.
So you got Battle Force. You got 3 for that.
I got Battalion Detachment.
Battalions. That's another 3.
Yes.
So that's 6.
And Outrider Detachment.
And Outrider. So you have 7.
7. Okay.
Okay, so you got 7. And okay, so that's cool. And any psychic powers here?
No,
Necrons.
Psychic.
Well, the Satan has the powers, but they don't count as psychic powers.
Exactly.
Okay, but you still do them in the psychic phase?
No, they're
Shooting
phase.
Attack.
Yeah.
Okay.
They're not shooting attack, but they happen in the shooting phase.
Cool. Okay, cool. First time on the channel, Necrons. It's going to be fun playing Necrons for the first time ever. I don't think I've ever played Necrons. So until recently, we never saw them. So okay, so we'll come back with the mission. Okay, so the mission we're playing is practicing Capital City Bloodbath mission, which is a combination of, this is mission 2, which is a combination of scouring and cleanse and capture. So scouring is the 6 objectives. We'll pick actually, you want to do that now? Why don't you roll which one's the major and which one's the minor?
Okay.
One of them is worth 4, the other worth 1, and then the rest are worth
5. 2.
So number 5 is the major. Where's number 5? 3, 4, 6. Oh, here's number 5. Okay, so this is the major. I'll write it down on the sheet of paper. And the minor is?
Also number 5.
You have to roll again. That one's worth 5 points.
2.
Number 2.
So that's 3 over here.
Okay, so the one in that rune over there is the minor. So the objectives are there, middle, here, here, and then number 4 there, and then behind that crate is number 6. Okay, and then cleanse and control is just and cleanse and capture is a 3 tactical cards per turn. You draw up to 3. So I got my cards, and we'll use the chart for Matt, and that's it. So Matt, actually, I started the point first, but Matt finished first, and so he'll get choice of first or second turn. He's deployed Scarabs over here, a unit of 20 warriors in that ruins, 20 warriors there, Scarabs here, the Satan's there, his HQs are there and there. Which one's your warlord?
The one Zandric there.
This guy here?
With the white.
Okay, and what trait did you pick?
The six up and vulnerable, the feel of pain.
Yeah, that's the best. Immortals are there, and the destroyers are over there. And then I've deployed in typical Dark Angels fashion in a castle right here, with my Tech Marine here and my Devastators in this ruin. Celestine starts in that ruins, and my scouts have made a little suicide bubble there. And my Eversers are in the Teleportarium. So that is basically the deployment, and I believe we are ready to go. Good game, Matt.
Good game.
All right. So, are you going first or second?
I'm going to go first.
Okay. I'm going to try and seize. Might as well. Here we go. And it's a fail. Okay. So, we're going to come back with Necrons turn one. Okay. So, Necrons turn one. Objective-wise, Matt rolled up a defend objective one and two. One is this one. Two is... that one. Did you get within three?
I'm nowhere near three.
And then hold the line, which is already abandoned. So before the turn started, the Satan teleported himself and Zandrek up to here. And then Zandrek has moved up there. And then Oberon can warp to Zandrek and bring this bunch of dudes with him. So that's pretty nasty. They're basically right on me. So it's not boding well for my line right now. The Satan is there. Destroyers have moved up there. Those guys didn't move. Raids have moved up here. Did those guys move?
Yep,
they moved a bit. Yep. And the Scarabs are wrapping around the back here. And there's nobody back there anymore. Okay, so that's the end of movement phase. So we'll come back at the end of the turn. And hopefully I still have something left. And yay. End of Necron's turn one. The warriors shot into the Dark Shroud and took one wound off. Otherwise, nothing else happened. Assault took a wound off the Razorback, and Celestine took four wounds off the Satan with nothing in return, and the Sergeant in the Devastator Squad died, and I think that's it. So you're holding that objective, but you have to hold it to the end of my turn. And, and you got First Blood with the Scouts. And then you're not on that one, you said, right? Okay, so we'll go on to Dark Angels turn one. Okay, my objectives for this turn are to secure objective 1, Kingslayer, which is Slay the Warlord, and Overwhelming Firepower, which is kill someone in the shooting phase. And basically, nothing has moved, except I fell back with that Razorback, and that one moved forward to allow it to do so. Okay, so end of Dark Angel's turn 1. It was some poor rolling, I gotta say. Celestine down to 1 wound in combat, did nothing in return. Couldn't kill this warrior squad, so now they're probably all gonna come back. Got Zandrek down to 2 and Oberon down to 2, and the assassin went in there and fluffed and died.
Sorry,
And that assassin failed his charge, even with a reroll. Managed to take this raise down to 2, which was not enough to force a test. And I think that's about it. I took one wound off a warrior there, and that is literally all I did on this turn. So, not great. So, we'll come back at... Yeah, so we'll come back at Necron's turn 2. Alright, Necron's turn 2. He pulled objective 4, objective 6, and no units in his own deployment zone. He has moved out all his units out of his zone. And the destroyers have moved this way. These guys regenerated 6 guys? 7 guys?
6.
Anyway, too many guys. And the Satan flew out of combat and is over there. And the rays have moved up here, and the scarabs have moved over here. So we'll come back at the end of the game. At end of the phase. Okay, so end of Necron's turn 2. The destroyers made it in and took a wound off. The rays made it in and took a couple of wounds off that Razorback. These guys failed. They tried to charge Celestine, and I killed one of these dudes in Overwatch, and that's about it. They took a wound off the assassin, and 3 wounds off the Dark Shroud. So that's it. That's the end of Necron's turn 2. Did you score anything? 4? Objective 4?
I abandoned that.
Oh, you abandoned, yeah. Yeah, but you're out of your zone and you got 6?
Yeah.
Okay, so you got 2 points there. And so on to Dark Angel's turn 2. Okay, so the end of Dark Angel's turn Two or three?
Two.
Just two. Wow. We're playing slow tonight. So I killed all the wraiths and all the destroyers. So that got me my one victory point. Unfortunately, I couldn't kill one more so I could get... Oh, and I killed the Zatan. So yeah. I killed three. So I got D3 for that. Three. Nice. Back in the game. And then Celestine consolidated over here. And then this tank is now down to four in combat, basically. And I took away a couple of immortals there and lost a wound in return. So we're going on to Necron's turn three. Okay, Matt rolled objective three, objective three, and objective three. Three different maelstroms. So he moved his scarabs onto objective three, and now he's got 3 points for that. Good old maelstrom. These guys advanced, these guys stayed in combat, and those guys reanimated a couple. These guys reanimated three guys, and that's all he's got left, actually. So we'll go come back at the end of the turn. So end of Necron turn three. These guys killed that Razorback and have consolidated. They consolidated, had to consolidate into Celestine, or chose to, and she killed four guys in return. Dreadnought down to two wounds, and killed an immortal with no response back there on the Evisor, and that is it. And of course, he scores 3 points. So Matt's definitely in the lead from the Maelstrom point of view. And we'll go on to Dark Angel's turn three. End of Dark Angel's turn three. I've almost wiped this unit out, including Warlord and Oberon. One guy I couldn't kill. They killed Celestine and she's reappeared over there on objective six, so that got me objective six. And we whittled this unit down quite significantly. And yeah, so I secure objective six. And I could have gotten hold the line if I killed that dude.
Yeah, I know.
Okay, so I got that. So I scored just that 1 point this turn. And that's it. So we go on to Necron's turn four. All right, Necron turn four. He rolled objective four, one, and two. And he doesn't have much left. Those scarabs have moved back that way. These guys stayed put. And he rezzed a whole bunch of these guys and rezzed just one immortal. And he rezzed... We could only put three of these guys. Thank God for the FAQ. He rolled seven, but he can only fit three within an inch of the one guy remaining and out of 1 inch of me. So small miracles. Okay, we'll come back at the end of the phase. End of Necron's turn four. Basically, that unit's gone, and the immortals are gone, and a couple wounds off this tank. So, and he scored objective one. So it's 8-4 currently on the Maelstrom. So we'll go into Dark Angel's turn four. Okay, so on my turn, I rolled behind enemy lines, objective four and objective one. And I've moving out. Razorbacks come up this way. Everything is pushed forwards. This Predator advanced up to there. Celestine active faith and moved. So she's over there on that objective. And Evisor is tucked in on number six behind there. Come back at the end of the turn. Okay, so end of Dark Angel's turn four, we've called it. I wiped out this unit here, and so he just has scarabs, and I'm on basically, I will be on every objective, so we called it. What a very interesting game. I thought after that, your first turn, when all that appeared in my face, like that's the last thing a gun line wants,
right? Yeah, exactly.
And I'm thinking now I need more chaff. I need maybe another unit of scouts, and maybe drop an Evisor for it. Yeah. I think you probably thought you had it in the bag too.
I had it in the bag. It's just my rolls went kaplap. I couldn't wound and I couldn't make any saves.
Yeah.
And that's what's needed. Like I took out your, Azrael's, abilities with my Lord's, counter tactics. It practically nullified your bubble.
Yeah.
But I just couldn't do anything.
Yeah, so you had very little high strength weapons.
Yeah.
To wound all my vehicles, and even without my 4 plus bubble, it was they still survived. Like all you killed was one Razorback, right?
Yep.
So that was
In close combat, I wasn't doing anything either, and I have high strength in close combat with my Lords.
Yeah.
They just couldn't deliver.
So I tell you what, this kind of list is very prevalent
in
competitive meta. So what do you think you can do to get yourself some more vehicle killing power?
I'd probably drop A 20-man warrior squad and try to get some more destroyers or something in there. Get better dice, because if my race got in there and they didn't take as much wounds as they did, they probably did a lot more damage.
Okay, well, yeah. But you know, dice is dice, right? Yes. So, but you're only rocking strength 5 shooting at the strongest, right?
Well, it's, again, that's what's learning with Necrons, right? They don't really have much high strength weapons. It's back in 8th edition, vehicles were very susceptible because I could always glance you to death, right? Now that's changed. I still need to wound you on 5s. You still got your armor save, which is only -1. Vehicles are a lot tougher in 8th edition.
How about Stalkers?
Stalkers?
Annihilation barges.
Get blown up by your las cannons.
Doomsday barges.
They'll get blown up by your las cannons.
Well, that's everything gets blown up by las cannons.
Well, that's the problem. Marines can spam las cannons, and every counter I have in my army would probably get blown up easily, right? Again.
Not with quantum shielding.
Quantum shielding is still, I still have to roll.
Yeah, but then you're only going to take 1 or 2 damage
exactly.
Out of per
so
las cannon.
I'm going to try Ghost Arcs with a blob. I don't have Doomsday Arcs, but I do have 2 Stalkers I want to try. But the Stalkers get no bonuses in armies at all in Necron armies because they're not a dynasty, which is kind of sucky. There's other lists I can try.
Okay.
But the Blob seemed to do really well. I just get on the wounds.
No, I thought my objectives were placed bad for me, and so when you hit me turn 1, I thought the whole game I'm not moving, right?
Yeah.
Like, I'm just going to keep falling back an inch and trying to shoot things, right? And it didn't feel like in the first 2 turns I had anywhere near enough firepower to get through these freaking people.
Warriors, yeah, the blob.
Yeah, man, it's that down to 1, and potentially I would have been 8.
Yeah.
Back up to 8, it's crazy. But what a great game, and thanks for playing, Matt.
Thanks for having me.
And I hope we do see you out at the Capital City Bloodbath.
Yeah.
Speaking of Capital City Bloodbath, people, it's in 3 weeks, so get your tickets. There's still lots of space for Warhammer, AOS, Batman, and War Machine, and I think we got Hobbit as well. You get lunch with your admission, so it's going to be a great day. So CapitalCityBloodbath.com for all the details. Thanks for watching us here and on Facebook, and support us on Patreon.com/Canhammer. Thanks very much for watching, and tune in next time. See you later, Matt.
Have a good one.